Hello friends, in this video I am going to show you how to calculate a passing pawn. How many times in your games you lose because you did not calculate correctly whether you can catch a passing pawn with a king. Especially in Blitz or Blitz games where you don't have much time, how can you quickly calculate this? I will show you, have a look at this example where the pawn is at d5 and the king is at g7. So do you think, pause this video and try to calculate quickly whether you'll be able to catch this passing pawn or not. So there is one way, you can go step by step and then figure it out whether you can calculate it or whether you can catch it or not. But of course this step by step will take a lot of time. So I show you the step by step way. So pawn to c6, king to f7, pawn to c7, king to e8, and then pawn to c8 and promotion to queen, and then you realize oops, not able, and then you suddenly lose the match. But if you let me show you, if you make this diagonal, say for example, so the pawn was at c5 and you make this diagonal and then you make a box like this. If the opponent's king and your king be able to enter into the boundary of this wall, then your king be able to catch this pawn. So here, since this king is outside the boundary of this wall, the king was not able to catch it, which I just show you earlier. Say, for example, your king is now at f7, which is now inside the boundaries of this wall. Now the king be able to catch this pawn. So, see this. This trick is helpful, especially when your pawn and the king are a bit far. So then you can you cannot spend a lot of time to calculate step by step, and that step by step way is a little error prone. So here you can quickly know that whether this king be able to catch this pawn or not. So do let me know if you find this little trick helpful, and it will help you save or win few games. I will keep on making more videos and smaller videos on the chess end games. I hope this will you will find it helpful. Till then, take care. Bye bye.